We are back today at Daniel 4 and verse 27, because God gave me another devotional thought that I thought I would share with you. This is about King Nebuchadnezzar having been warned by Daniel about the consequences of pride or sin. But King Nebuchadnezzar thought that he could sort of escape those consequences. He could continue to live for himself and be proud and somehow escape the judgment and the consequences of his sins. Isn't it true that we do not want consequences for our sins? We think that we can live our lives the way we want without consequences. The flesh wishes to lie without consequences, to cheat, to have a fling, to commit adultery without consequences. And somehow we think we can escape consequences. That's how sin deceives us. That's how sin fools us, to think that we can get away scot-free. But that is a lie, because there is a law of life. Galatians 6 and verses 9 and 10 tells us, be not deceived. Don't be fooled. God is not mocked. Whatsoever man sows, that shall he also reap. If he sows to the Spirit, he will of the Spirit reap life. But if he sows to the flesh, he shall of the flesh reap corruption, decay, dying. You can't change that. When you sin, when you sow sin, you will reap the death, the consequences of sin. Your sin will find you out, Bible tells us. And therefore, sins bring consequences. You die a little each time when you disobey. You know, the Word of God is given to set us free. To set us free from sin and its bondage and its consequences. The Word of God is not to restrict us, but to release us. It does not call us to legalism, but liberty. It calls us to free ourselves from ruining ourselves and to live unto God. My friends, learn to break off sins in the power that the Holy Spirit provides, and there will be blessings in obedience. There will be tranquility in verse 27. There will be a lengthening of your life. Because otherwise sin harms you, hurts you, and it is so unnecessary. So may God help us today to be freed from the deceit and the lies of sin. God bless.